गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम निशा सिंधी एंड आई एम टेकिंग सेकेंड स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स रिवाइज द पोयम नंबर 1, द फील्ड माउस। द फील्ड माउस। लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट स्टैंजा, वेयर द एकॉर्न टम्बल्स डाउन, वेयर द ऐश ट्री शेड्स इट्स बेरी, विथ योर फर सो सॉफ्ट एंड ब्राउन, with your eye so round and merry, scarcely moving the long grass, field mouse, I can see you pass. In the first stanza of the poem, poet want to say that this poem is based on a field mouse which has a soft fur and round eyes and moves through the long grass when the acorn or oak nut fruit and berry fall on the ground. The mouse is seen at this time as it comes out of its hole to eat the fruit. Let's read the second stanza of the poem. Little thing in what dark den lie you all the winter sleeping, till warm weather comes again, then once more I see you peeping round about the tall tree roots, nibbling at their fallen fruits. In the second stanza of the poem, poet want to say that the poet asks the mouse what it does during winter season, hiding in its hole. What the field mouse doing in the winter season, hiding in its hole? Because the mouse is only seen during summers, peeping from the hole. The mouse is only seen during summers, coming out from the hole. On the trees, the mouse comes out to feed on the fruits of the trees. On the trees, the mouse comes out to feed on the fruits of the trees. Let's read the third stanza of the poem. Field mouse, do not go where the farmer stacks his treasure. Find the nut that falls below. Eat the corn at your pleasure, but you must not steal the grain he has stacked with so much pain. Field mouse, do not go where the farmer stacks his treasure. Find the nut that falls below. Eat the corn at your pleasure, but you must not steal the grain he has stacked with so much pain. So students, in the third stanza, poet want to say that the poet requests the mouse not to eat the grains that farmers grow by working hard. He requests the mouse to eat only the fruits that are fallen on the ground. In this third stanza of the poem, the poet requests the mouse not to eat the grains that farmers grow by working hard. He requests the mouse to eat only the fruits that are fallen on the ground. Let's read the fourth stanza of the poem. Make your hole where mooses spring, underneath the tall oak shadow. Pretty, quiet, harmless thing, play about the sunny meadow. Keep away from corn and house, none will harm you, little mouse. Make your hole where mooses spring, underneath the tall oak shadow. Pretty, quiet, harmless thing, play about the sunny meadow. Keep away from corn and house, none will harm you, little mouse. In the fourth stanza of the poem, poet again requests the mouse to make hole, the place where mouse lives, under the tall oak tree and not in the house or near the stored grains. And in this way, nobody would harm mouse.
Poet again requests the mouse to make hole. The hole, the place where mouse lives, under the tall oak tree, and not in the house or near the stored grains. And in this way, nobody could harm mouse. So students, hope you understood the poem, The Field Mouse. So read the poem, The Field Mouse. Now let's take the some of the hard words. Acorn, meaning of acorn is the nut of an oak tree. Scarcely, meaning of scarcely. Hardly. Tumbles down, meaning of tumbles down is falls to ground. Sheds, meaning of sheds is to get rid of something. Of sheds is to get rid of something. Now it's time to take the homework. Read and write hard words and also read the poem The Field Mouse and write the hard words in your English homework notebook and send on WhatsApp. Thank you.